Hello everyone, this is the Karel Roy HD here, and if you remember from my Devolver review when I did gameplay footage edited into the review, a lot of people actually emailed me from my Twitter account or even on Discord from my old account. A lot of people were wondering how did I got it to work on the PC's Project Devolver Arcade, and I gave the answer from the credit and answer from Shrink Review, but it seems a lot of people gotten confused with it, so I decided to do this small little tutorial here. So we're going to install everything you need from here. It's going to be into the modding server. We'll link the modding server invite to the link in description below so you can get the download files, but please be respectful to the modders and modding community. Now with that being said, let's get started. First, you're going to obviously need the Devolver, and second, you're going to go into the modding server and go into tools. Now, the only thing you need in tools is a Devolver custom firmware update from the latest version that was in February 1st, 2020 from Shrink Read. So we're going to download that. I already have it downloaded, so I'm not going to redo it. But once downloaded, you're going to open it and you're going to have two folders for firmware and hooks. Now, you can drag it into the desktop or just do what I did, just put it specifically in its own separate folder. You can use it from in the desktop or your own folder, but I use my own folder because it makes it easier. Now what we're going to do, we're going to install the firmware first using the updater. We're going to install both the host and LED for the controller so it can correspond. Now let's head to the Devolver. Once we're at the Devolver, what you're going to do is connect the LED USB-C cable to either your PC or to a AC wall adapter. I'm using AC wall adapter, and for the power for the Devolver, we're going to plug it into the computer first, which you can use backup motherboard or USB 3.0 onto your PC. And before we plug it into the Devolver, you're actually going to hold down left, down, and right first. And then while holding it down, you're then going to insert it into the Devolver. When you're inserting the USB into the Devolver and holding down the corresponding buttons, you should see that the light for the touch slider will come on, but the buttons will not. This is a normal response. Now, we're going to go right back to the PC and open the updater. Now, once we open up the updater, we're going to install the host MCU update first. Click connect, and it should get connected, and open the file, which is the host file first, and then hit update. You should get a success. Now, once you get success, what you're going to do is hit disconnect and unplug your Devolver. And once you unplug your Devolver, we're going to do the other button correspondence, holding down R1, R2, and R3, and connect the Devolver's USB cord again. Now, this time, the four buttons should light up, but the touch slider shouldn't. This is, again, a normal response. Now going back to the PC, we're going to install the LED, which was updated from the first initial release that fixed the lighting issue. Same thing, connect, install the LED update, .bin, open, and hit update, and it should give another success. Now what you're going to do, you're going to unplug the Devolver again for the last time, at least for this step. And when you plug it in, you should get a pop-up in the lower right corner saying installing myself controller, which is normal. But in case you're going to use the protocol, which is the yellow button and R3, press both of them together once you reconnect the Devolver, and the four buttons should light up, and you should get in the lower right corner of it showing installing the myself controller. Once you do that, we're going to go to the next way to update, the Z dial, or how you say it. I probably butchered that, but that's the second. Then what you're going to do, you're going to hit your option, list all devices. Basically, you're going to find the Myself controller, which is the name of it, and you're going to install the WinUSB on Myself Interface 4, in some cases both Interface 4 and Interface 3. I already have mine installed. It's going to should say install driver, and once success, you can go ahead and X out of it. And then the last thing we're going to do is open up the hooks, go to where your correspondent Project Diva Arcade folder is for Arcade Future Tone, and you're going to drag, or basically copy and paste, or drag for copy and paste, all the DLLs in the inject.exe, start, bat, and Sega tool. But for me, I always rename it to divahook.bat, but it can be either one from start.bat or divahook.bat. When you get the replace or decline, you can just go ahead and replace these. But I recommend you backing it up first, in case something happens. In a version of PD Loader I'm using here, I'm using the latest version, Project Diva Loader 2.6.58 at the time. Before we actually launch the game and test it out on the Diva, we actually want to open up the .exe and get these settings. You want to make sure if you're going to do online or not, you can use the divahook.bat option down here so it'll launch it automatically. For me, I always use the timer sprites because I want to feel more like the arcade. But more importantly, you have to go to components, frame rate manager to keep it at a constant 60 frames per second. Disable the input and slider emulator if you're not going to use a different controller, and enable a touch panel emulator. And lastly, disable the render on patch. The reason why, because if you have it on for some reason, it doesn't let the buttons on the Devler work in the menu, but gameplay is perfectly fine. But it needs to be disabled and get the full experience. Now, let's test it. Let's run and test it. Now, the camera, of course, is a bit shaky because of my hand, but the hand is showing the Devler. The cam is showing the Devler. It's acting just like the arcade controller panel cabinet on all LEDs and sliders. Yes, this does work on no matter which version, from the Dawa version or the Sanwa version. If you want information on how to set up the online server, I recommend you just joining the Discord server, but please be really respectful to the rules of the server. And I'm not going to do any gameplay, just show how the buttons lights work. See the buttons, the LED, and everything work corresponding almost like the arcade, if not exact. Now, let's do the slider in gameplay. I hope this tutorial was a bit helpful at least. If you have any questions about installing this, you can drop it in the comment sections, and I'll do my best to reply. With that, have a nice day.